You start, really. A perfect world. Free from all the evil that had corrupted each and every corner of the known and unknown universe. It was going to be a place of safety for the kids. The little yous. You little... Well, so far, so good. But things started to go wrong soon after you arrived. Now, I can understand your initial shock coming face to face with Maxis, especially after so long. But you did the right thing. You followed the plan. You brought the summoning key here, and you destroyed that bloody machine once and for all. Thing is, Maxis went and ballsed everything up.
My God, what have I done? Stop it, Edward. Breathe. It's okay. Maxis!
Shows him a good time, yeah? Yes, patient! We're really very busy today! Here, let me help you die! This has nothing to do with me. I can promise you that. When life gives you lemons, attempt to weaponize lemonade.
Where is he? Where is Dr. Monty? He will help us, just as Max has promised.
Physically. I would advise you not to deny me. I will hold on to this. Why? It feels good. That's why. You know, I sometimes feel guilty about Sammy. But then I remember, it wasn't really me. The time for warnings is over, mein Hellspawn. And you will provoke a response.
I'm so close. We can still avert disaster. We can still set things right. The blood vials will protect me.
I don't think you appreciate how much of this is an act of mercy. It's rude, really. Eagerness to vanquish the Horde has left me low on ammo. Surprise, surprise.
No bullets. How did this happen?
All right, I wasn't being careful.
I had many dreams whilst in these trenches. I say dreams, but really they were more like visions. Starting with the one where Maxis begged me to remove his brain. It really isn't what it used to be.
Even less since I started talking.
Kaboom.
Cannot argue with your message, Dr. Monty. Their effectiveness speaks volumes. You're interested in one of my discount lobotomies.